As a cadet for 4 years at Staunton Military Academy, I daily passed the bust of Major Tom Howie, proudly enshrined in front of Cable Hall, and so it was, as I came to visit the Normandy American Cemetery, natural to seek him out. The cemetery, comprising 172.5 acres near the French town of Saint-Laurent-sur-Mer, sits atop a bluff overlooking Omaha Beach, the site of the heaviest fighting on D-Day, June 6, 1944. Of the 9,386 military dead interred here, most died on the beach and in the ensuing breakout that lasted nearly 2 months. Plot G, Row 14, Grave 12, marks the remains of Tom Howie and is singularly unremarkable from all the rest in their long, uniform, eloquent rows. But the man honored here was singularly remarkable in all that he touched in his too short life. From Abbeville, South Carolina, to St. Lo, France, he blazed a trail marked by excellence. At the Citadel, the Thomas Dry Howie Carillon contains one of the largest Dutch bell installations in the Western Hemisphere. Chosen by his classmates as the most versatile, most popular, and best all around, he was senior class president, star halfback of the football team, captain of the baseball team, and a boxer. Upon graduation, he went to Staunton Military Academy to teach English and coach football. In 8 seasons as head football coach, he won 4 Virginia Military School League championships, as well as being a mentor, guide, and example to 11 years of Staunton cadets. He was husband to Elizabeth Payne Howie, who he met and married in 1932. Father to Sally Elizabeth Howie McDevitt, born in 1938. In 1941, his Virginia National Guard unit was activated for intensive training, and Second Lieutenant Howie left Staunton for the last time. Famous as the Major of St. Lo, Thomas Howie led the 3rd Battalion, 116th Infantry, 29th Division, during the Normandy campaign. For 41 days, he and his men fought in the hedgerows, closing in on St. Lo, a vital transportation hub for the Germans that Hitler ordered held at all cost. As the battle for St. Lo raged, Major Howie spoke on the battle phone with his commander, Major General Charles Gerhardt, and was heard to say, "Yes, we can do it if we jump off right now. Okay, see you in St. Lo." But as fate would have it, he was just then struck and killed by a mortar fragment. Remembering Thomas Howie's last statement, General Gerhardt ordered his body sent into St. Lo, and his men, dodging sniper fire, placed his flag-draped body on the rubble of a collapsed church wall. And Major Howie was indeed first into St. Lo. Leaving the cemetery, I traveled to the town of Bayeux and the D-Day Museum there. The news clippings and photographs on display there show the almost total destruction of St. Lo and its surroundings. In the town of St. Lo, the church has been rebuilt and a plaque attached to the wall marking the spot where his body lay. Driving away from the church, I shortly found myself in a traffic circle in whose perimeter stood a granite monument, an enormous American flag with the bust of Thomas Howie centrally mounted. Not having expected this monument, the sight of the bust, an exact replica of the one at Staunton, was a very surreal moment. At the monument's base reads the inscription, "Fallen at the head of his troops while liberating our village," with the rallying cry, "See you in St. Lo." This was late July, and the still fresh flowers adorning the monument attest to the fact that the French also remember. July 18th, 1944.